Good morning, everyone. So we have already started with our chapter of French Revolution. We have almost covered the half of the chapter. And in our next class, we actually finally saw how did France become a republic after the execution of King Louis XVI and the Queen. Now we come across the next ruler who had the power to rule over France. So we saw in our previous class that the most influential या सबसे जो important Jacobian club था उनके leader थे Maximilian Robespierre. तो Maximilian Robespierre जो है अब सारा का सारा France को rule करने का power आ गया उनके हाथ में in the republican form of government. But his time period or you can say the time when he ruled is considered the reign of terror. रेन ऑफ टेरर क्यों बोलते हैं? रेन मतलब रूल, टाइम पीरियड जब कोई रूल करता है तो उसको रेन ऑफ टेरर क्यों बोलते हैं? क्योंकि जो उनका रूल था ना वो बहुत ज्यादा स्ट्रिक्ट था. कि एक्चुअली आई सपोज टेरर सबको पता है टेरर का मतलब होता है डर जैसे. तो क्यों? बिकॉज ही फॉलोड अ पॉलिसी ऑफ सिवियर कंट्रोल एंड पनिशमेंट. वो क्या करते थे, उनको जब भी लगता था ना कि समबडी इज एक्चुअली द एनिमी ऑफ द रिपब्लिक, चाहे वो एक्स नोबल्स हो, चाहे वो क्लर्जीमैन हो, चाहे वो मेंबर ऑफ अदर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी हो, इवन तक कि अगर उसके खुद के पार्टी के मेंबर हो तो उनको भी क्या करवाते थे, ये पहले इम्प्रिजन करते थे, फिर उनको ट्राइड का मतलब क्या है कि केस चलता था इनका. कहाँ पे चलता था केस? बाय रेवोल्यूशनरी ट्रिब्यूनल. ठीक है, यानी उनका केस चलता था इन वन यू कैन से कोर्ट काइंड ऑफ थिंग विच वॉज कॉल्ड द और यू कैन से इट वॉज कॉल्ड अ रेवोल्यूशनरी ट्रिब्यूनल. ट्रिब्यूनल क्यों? क्योंकि यहाँ पे केसेस चलते थे. केसेस किसके चलते थे? केसेस चलते थे जिनके ऊपर भी शक होता था Maximilian Robespierre को कि दे आर एनिमीज ऑफ द रिपब्लिक, तो उनके ऊपर केस चलता था. एंड इफ फाउंड गिल्टी दे वर गिलोटिन. गिलोटिन क्या होता है? इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू पोल्स एंड वन ब्लेड एंड विथ विच अ पर्सन इज बीहेडेड. बीहेडेड का मतलब क्या है यहाँ पे? कि इसका मतलब है कि जब वो एक पर्सन होता है हु इज कंसिडर्ड गिल्टी तो उसको पनिश कैसे करते हैं? एक रॉड होता है और दो प्लैंक्स जैसे होते हैं, जो प्लैंक्स होते हैं उसके ऊपर शार्प ब्लेड होती है. तो जो पर्सन जिसको पनिश करते हैं उसको नीचे वाले प्लैंक के ऊपर उनको अपना हेड रखना पड़ता है, नेक बेसिकली, और ऊपर से फोर्सफुली वो जो दूसरा प्लैंक है जिसमें शार्प ब्लेड होती है वो ऊपर से एकदम फोर्सफुली गिरती है ओवर दी नेक ऑफ दैट पर्सन एंड दैट इज व्हाई द नेक ऑफ दैट पर्सन इज फाइनली चॉप्ड ऑफ. तो ये एक बहुत ही सीरियस काइंड ऑफ पनिशमेंट था जो रॉबस्पियर के टाइम पे लोगों को दिया जाता था, हूएवर वाज कंसिडर्ड गिल्टी. और ये जो इंस्ट्रूमेंट है इसको या ये जो डिवाइस है इसको इन्वेंट किया था डॉक्टर गिलोटिन ने, इसीलिए ही इस डिवाइस का नाम गिलोटिन रखा गया था. और जिसको भी पनिश किया जाता था उनको बोला जाता था कि दैट पर्सन वाज गिलोटिन, इज गिलोटिन. सो इमेजिन कि इतनी ज्यादा हार्श पनिशमेंट मिलती थी इन हिज टाइम पीरियड. दैट इज व्हाई पीपल वर रियली स्केयर्ड इन हिज टाइम पीरियड. वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग रिगार्डिंग हिज टाइम पीरियड वॉज ही वॉन्टेड टू एस्टैब्लिश इक्वालिटी, बट ही वॉन्टेड टू एस्टैब्लिश इक्वालिटी थ्रू फोर्स. ठीक है, कैसे थ्रू फोर्स? मतलब वो हर चीज के ना स्ट्रिक्ट रूल्स कर रहे थे. कैसे? मीट और जो ब्रेड है उनको राशन कर दिया गया था, मतलब आप बहुत ज्यादा खरीद नहीं सकते हो. आपकी जो वेजेस है या चीजों के जो प्राइजेस है उसकी लिमिट कर दी थी कि इससे ज्यादा मैक्सिमम आपके वेजेस नहीं बढ़ सकते हैं. पेजेंट्स जो है उनको फोर्स किया जाता था कि आप जो है अपने ग्रेन ट्रांसपोर्ट करोगे टू द सिटीज एंड यू विल सेल इट ओनली टू द गवर्नमेंट एट अ फिक्स प्राइस. देन एट दैट टाइम देयर यूज टू बी टू काइंड ऑफ ब्रेड, ठीक है, एक तो व्हाइट ब्रेड होती थी व्हाइट फ्लोर की जनरली जैसे मैदे टाइप की, और जो एक और ब्रेड होती थी जो होल व्हीट की बनी होती थी. एट दैट टाइम होल व्हीट ब्रेड जो है इट वॉज कम्पेरेटिवली चीपर. सो ही इंट्रोड्यूस इक्वालिटी ब्रेड. अभी इक्वालिटी ब्रेड क्या थी, ओनली ब्रेड मेड ऑफ होल व्हीट एंड पीपल हैड टू बाय दैट ओनली. मतलब वेदर यू आर रिच वेदर यू आर पुअर वेदर यू वॉन्ट टू हैव व्हाइट ब्रेड और यू वॉन्ट टू हैव ब्राउन ब्रेड यू कैन हैव ओनली दैट ब्रेड विच इज कॉल्ड द इक्वालिटी ब्रेड. नाउ instead of then you have if many of you have if you have taken French you may be knowing कि जो सर है उनको बोलते हैं monsieur और जो मतलब ladies है उनको बोलते हैं madam. तो ये जो terms है ये भी अब use नहीं करनी है. इसकी जगह सारे French और men और women जो है उनको citizen ही माना जाएगा citoyen और citoyenne. तो ही उसके बाद देन व्हाट एल्स डिड ही डू कि एक्चुअली जो चर्च थी उनको शट डाउन कर दिया गया एंड जो बिल्डिंग थी दे वर एक्चुअली नाउ कन्वर्टेड इनटू ऑफिसेस एंड बैरिस. अब व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय दिस, वी मीन दैट ही वांटेड टू एनफोर्स इक्वालिटी. इक्वालिटी कैन नॉट बी ब्रॉट बाय फोर्स अंटिल एंड अनलेस वी ourselves consider everyone as equal and we follow equality. कोई अपने को force नहीं कर सकता that you will have to consider yourself equal to the other person. It can be brought either slowly through various governmental measures or it can be brought only by the you can say change in the mind of the people. You cannot force somebody that आपको सबको equally चीजें खानी पड़ेगी. It depends on you. See, it's a simple thing. If you want to buy branded clothes, it is up to you. If you want to buy homemade, if you want to buy, suppose, some clothes that are locally made, it is your choice. Nobody can force you. It depends on you and the kind of status you belong to. But he wanted ki sab log equal hone chahiye aur iske liye main kya karunga, forcefully aise tarike apnaunga jisse people will finally become equal. And these, you can say, these practices or these policies that he wanted to use were very, very extreme. So people were slowly and gradually not accepting it. They were upset, they were disappointed, and they were not happy with it. So, but he continued to follow his policies relentlessly. You have to follow ही करने पड़ेंगे ये सारी की सारी चीजें. अब धीरे धीरे क्या हो गया, जो रॉकस्टर के सपोर्टर्स थे ना वो भी उनको ये चीज समझाने लग गए कि सर आप थोड़ी मॉडरेशन लाओ, इतने एक्सट्रीम मत बनो, इतने स्ट्रिक्ट मत बनो. इफ यू वांट टू ब्रिंग चेंजेस फॉर इट स्लोली यू गेट दी चेंजेस, थोड़ी ग्रेजुअली लाओ, ऐसे यू फोर्सफुली कैन नॉट डू इट. बट ही डिड नॉट लिसन टू एनीवन. फाइनली उसकी जो पॉलिसी इतनी एक्सट्रीम हो गई थी एंड पीपल वर सो डिसअपॉइंटेड by whatever he was doing that finally he was convicted by the court in 1794. He was arrested, case was done against him and on the next day he himself was guillotined. yani wo jinko punishment jis hisab ki de rahe the same punishment was given to him and he was guillotined. So now we see the end of one more ruler of France. अब क्या सिचुएशन होगी, अगेन द हेड ऑफ द कंट्री इज मिसिंग एंड नोबडी इज देयर टू टेक केयर. नाउ अगेन दे थॉट व्हाट शुड बी डन. अब एक नया कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वापस इंट्रोड्यूस किया गया विच डिनाइड द वोट टू नॉन प्रॉपर्टी सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी. नाउ अब क्या हुआ, इफ यू रिमेम्बर जैकोबियन क्लब में वो वाले मेंबर्स थे जो लोग हम देखेंगे कि दीज वर द पीपल हु वर वेरी पुअर. तो अब जो है पावर आ गया था इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द रिच मिडिल क्लास. दे अगेन वांटेड टू टेक द पावर. अब जो ये वेल्दी और मिडिल क्लास है दे थॉट नाउ वी शुड हैव ऑल द पावर एंड अ न्यू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड विच डिनाइड द यू कैन से वोटिंग राइट्स टू पीपल हु डिड नॉट हैव प्रॉपर्टी. That means if you have the property and especially obviously men, if you have property, whether it is land, whether it is you can say some kind of house और आपके पास बस कोई प्रॉपर्टी होनी चाहिए. इफ यू हैव सम प्रॉपर्टी देन यू विल नोटिस दैट यू हैव द राइट टू वोट. अब इनका सिस्टम क्या था कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में, इस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में थी दो इलेक्टेड लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल और ये जो लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल थी दी अपॉइंटेड अ डायरेक्टरी. नाउ व्हाट वाज अ डायरेक्टरी, अ डायरेक्टरी वाज अ एग्जीक्यूटिव मेड अप ऑफ फाइव मेंबर्स. यानी देयर वर फाइव मेंबर्स हु वर कंसीडर्ड द एग्जीक्यूटिव यानी कि लॉ इंप्लीमेंटिंग बॉडी. दो लेजिस्लेटिव इलेक्टेड काउंसिल थे जो इलेक्ट कर जो चूज अपॉइंट करते थे एक एग्जीक्यूटिव के एक एग्जीक्यूटिव को जिसमें होते थे फाइव मेंबर्स. ठीक है, ये इन्होंने इसलिए किया था क्योंकि इन्होंने नोटिस किया कि लास्ट टाइम जब रॉक्सफेयर अकेले के पास सारे पावर थे यानी व्हेन वन सिंगल पर्सन हैज ऑल द पावर ही एक्चुअली बिकम्स वेरी अथॉरिटेटिव. यानी उनकी जो मर्जी होती है उस हिसाब से दैट पर्सन टेक्स डिसीजन. सो ही थॉट दैट सॉरी दे थॉट दैट दिस टाइम वी शुड हैव अ एग्जीक्यूटिव बॉडी which is not having one member. So they decided it to be five members. Now what happened? The problem was that ye jo directors the, yani ye jo five members the, inki often kya hoti thi? Ladai hoti thi. Aur kisse hoti thi ladai inki? Inki ladai hoti thi with the legislative council. Aur legislative council jo hai wo inko dismiss kar dete the. Phir dusre ko appoint karte the. Phir dismiss appoint. So ye problematic situation aa gayi. वापस से यहाँ पे क्या हो गया, पॉलिटिकल इनस्टेबिलिटी हो गई. और इसका फायदा किसने उठाया, एक मिलिट्री डिक्टेटर नेम्ड एज नेपोलियन बोनापार्टे. ही इज कंसिडर्ड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट रूलर ऑफ फ्रांस अबाउट विच वी विल स्टडी ब्रीफली टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड इन डिटेल इन योर नेक्स्ट क्लास दैट इज इन योर 10th क्लास. So you should remember that he was a very important personality, a very important ruler of France, and he got the, you can say, opportunity to hold on power because of the political instability of the dynasty. So with this we come across end of one phase of the French Revolution. So with this we can say that somewhat the whole French Revolution was put to an end. And the new phase, that is the rise of the Napoleon, will be something that we will study about later. Now, let us see what was the role of women in the revolution and what were the changes that were brought in the life of the women before and after the revolution. Initially, jo women hai, they took very active participation in all the events of the French Revolution. They always were the important participants in the revolution. So, and we will see later that it brought changes in their life and society, but it did not give a major political change, or you can say it did not give political rights to the women. Though some of the things were improved if we talk in terms of their social life. So let us briefly see their life before the revolution. Before the revolution, most of the women jo hai of the third estate had to work for living. And what kind of work did they do? They used to sell vegetables, they used to sell fruits, they used to work as domestic servants in the houses of the prosperous people. What else they used to do? They actually, these third estate women also had to manage their house along with working outside. Now, most women actually did not have the access to education or job training at that time. Matlab, at that time, women were as such not allowed, generally not allowed to get educated. Only daughters of nobles or the wealthier members of the third estate could study and that too at a convent school. After which, that is when they completed their studies and the schooling, they had to get married, and marriage was obviously arranged and everything was decided by the family, and specifically agar apne dekhe by their father, they did not have any right to say yes or no. All the decisions for them were taken by their fathers only. As I already told you that the working women also had to take care of the families. They had to cook, they had to queue up, they had to stand in line to buy bread and take care of their families. One more problem that they were facing was their wages were very less as compared to those of men. Now, what happened that we have already studied when I was telling you about the political club of the that emerged during the time when we saw that Jacobean clubs were also emerging. At that time, I told you that many of the women clubs were also becoming important. So, in order to discuss and voice their interest, women started many political clubs and newspapers. There were about 60 women clubs that came up in different French cities. One of the most important one was Society of Revolutionary and Republican Women. One of the most famous, and we should know its name because we will study more about it regarding one of its great leaders. So, ye jo Society of Revolutionary and Republican Women hai, was one of the most important women political clubs of that time. And it is also important from the point of view of your one mark question because it is generally asked that which was the famous or the most important women political club of during the French Revolution. So you should know about this. So now moving on to the next thing is that now what happened after the revolution, during the revolution, women played very important role. Now they thought that we will get some kind of rights after the revolution. Yani revolution ke baad voting rights to milenge hame koi na koi na political office yani koi na koi ministry bhi mil jayegi. Matlab electors ya jo national assembly usme bhi hame milega. But total disappointment क्योंकि 1791 में उनको मिनिस्ट्री तो छोड़ो वोटिंग राइट तो छोड़ो उनको पैसिव सिटीजन ही बना दिया था. पैसिव सिटीजन का क्या मतलब? Those who were not even given the right to vote. So they were really really disappointed after the constitution of 1791. So they continued to raise their voice for equal political rights. But we can say that some changes were introduced. Okay. Now, what were the changes that were introduced if we say in terms of during the this constitution of 1791? Now, the laws that were introduced were including their education. Now, what was their education? The education mein kya kardi thi? Schooling was made compulsory for all the girls. Aur state schools khul gaye the jahan pe women ya girls ki jo education hai wo compulsory ho gayi thi. Ek aur cheez, their father could no longer force them into marriage against their will. Yani now this time they were asked. The girls were asked whether you are happy or whether you want to marry this particular person or not. And with that, some more changes were made, which was that marriages were now made into contract and it could be entered freely, matlab register hota tha under civil law. Divorce was made legal. Any side could apply for it, whether men or women, and they had to tell the reason. Now, after this, women were also given the right to, or you can say training for jobs, they were given. And they could also do small business or they could also do some artistic kind of work. These were the changes that came into their life when they were, you can say, given certain improvement if we talk in terms of their social status. After that, what else was done? Though social mein to aa gaye the changes. But what happened was they still wanted more rights or more rights to unko specifically kya chahiye the. They wanted political rights. So they continued to fight for their political rights. When they were fighting for their political rights, what happened was during the reign of terror, which was the time period of Robespierre. Robespierre actually was very strict, as you already know, and he did not encourage any political activity regarding women. So he issued laws ordering closure of women clubs and banning their political activity. Many prominent women were arrested, and then obviously you know what he used to do. Unko trial hota tha, and if they were considered guilty, they were executed. So their struggle for equal rights continued for next 200 years. So imagine that it continued for 200 years, and they still continue to fight. And why were they fighting? They were fighting because they wanted the right to vote. And whenever this, whenever women used to fight for this particular right all over the world, they used to consider the activities or the revolution done by the women as a inspiration or motivation. So हम देखेंगे यहाँ पे एक टर्म है सफरेज. सफरेज का क्या मतलब है? राइट टू वोट. यहाँ पे एस यू डबल एस ई आर सफर नहीं है, सफरेज है. सफरेज मूवमेंट मतलब राइट टू वोट वाले मूवमेंट. तो इंटरनेशनली लेट 19 और 20th सेंचुरी में ऑल ओवर दी वर्ल्ड और सब जगह जो है वीमेन वर फाइटिंग टू गेट द राइट टू वोट. एंड जो फ्रेंच वुमेन थी वो कहीं ना कहीं इंस्पिरेशन थी फॉर द वुमेन अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. फाइनली दे गॉट द राइट टू वोट इन 1946. ओके, सो फाइनली वुमेन इन फ्रांस गॉट द राइट टू वोट इन 1946. अगेन दिस डेट इज इम्पोर्टेंट. यू ऑल शुड रिमेम्बर दिस डेट बिकॉज इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ योर एग्जाम. वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन, ओके, और वुमेन पे भी आएगा, देन ऑल्सो दिस इज द कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट. नाउ वी हैव, देयर इज अ बॉक्स गिवन इन योर बुक इन पेज नंबर 19. सो ऑन योर पेज नंबर 19 द बॉक्स दैट इज गिवन टेल्स अस अबाउट वन इम्पोर्टेंट रेवोल्यूशनरी वुमेन. नाउ इफ यू रिमेम्बर वेन वी एक्चुअली स्टडीड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ 1791, he said that their constitution began with the declaration of rights of man and citizen. And there was a question in our mind, what about women? Why are they not talking about women? Why are they writing citizen? Why did they write men and citizen? So many women were protesting for it. So similar was the case of this lady. Now Olympe de Gouges was one of the most important politically active women revolutionary in France. And she protested against the constitution because she said, or she questioned, that why is it written declaration of rights of men and citizen? We should have written only citizen. Ya fir right of men and women, dono likh dete. Why are you writing this? That means you are not including women. Women are also human beings. They are also citizen of the country. So why are you not mentioning them, or why are you not giving them the fundamental rights? So in 1971, she wrote Declaration of Rights of Women and Citizens. ठीक है, यानी उसको contradict करने के लिए she wrote Declaration of Rights of Women and Citizens, and she said that now I want the Queen to accept it and act upon it. So she was saying because Queen is also a woman, so she should also take some action regarding it, regarding this. So she addressed it to the Queen, and she wanted the members of the National Assembly to act upon it. Now in 1793, that is, if you all remember that the Reign of Terror or the time period of Robespierre is 1793 to 94. Because he ruled only for 1 year, 1793 to 94. After which he was guillotined. And the next government came. So in 1793, she criticized the Jacobean government. Why? Because they forcefully were closing the women's club, political clubs, and women movements, etc. So she criticized them. And obviously, what will Robespierre do? He tried, that is, in the court case chala against Olympe de Gouges, and the case was by the National Convention. She was charged with treason. मतलब कि आप देश के खिलाफ कर रहे हो, यू आर डूइंग समथिंग विच इज अगेंस्ट योर ओन कंट्री, योर ओन नेशन. सो शी वॉज चार्ज विथ ट्रेजर एंड फाइनली शी वॉज ऑल्सो एग्जीक्यूटेड. That means she was also killed. But whatever it be, the women continued to fight, and result of which we saw that they finally got the right to vote. Though it was very late, but still they got the right to vote in 1946. And this was the, you can say, the role of women in the revolution. They played very important role, but they did not get the right to vote, and they did not get any political office. Thoda bahut improvement hua tha in their social status, but the changes were not that important if we talk in terms of the political situation, for which they continued to revolt, and finally they succeeded and they became the inspiration for the women all around the world, and people and women all around the world then fought for their right to vote and they got it. So this was it regarding the role of women in the French Revolution and the changes that were brought in the life of the women before and after the revolution. So today we did the Reign of Terror, that is the rule of Maximilian Robespierre, which is only 1 year, 1973 to 1974, because his rule was very strict and very rigid, because of which later he used to guillotine the people whom he considered as the culprit, or the people who have done certain kind of, who were the enemies to the republic and done something wrong and were not good for the country. And later on he himself was guillotined, because he was also considered like somebody who was taking actions very rigidly and very, you can say he was very strict about his policy. So after then we saw the coming of the directory, where there was two legislative council and then five directors, but they were always fighting or were not, you can say, coordinating with each other, because of which we saw the rise of the military dictator Napoleon Bonaparte, about which we will study in the next class. And then we saw the changes that came in the life of the women before and after the revolution, that they, matlab thodi si changes hue the, unki life wahi thi, jaise kaam karna, third estate ke bahar bhi kaam karna. Schooling से third estate के wealthier और nobles को allow की marriage, father decide करते थे और ऐसी ही life थी. After the revolution, शादी के लिए they could say yes or no, उनकी consent, मतलब उनसे पूछते थे, consent लेते थे. उसके बाद जो marriage है वो एक legal civil law में register होती थी, contract भी, मतलब contract sign होता था. Divorce हो सकता था, they could do now work, business, schooling हो गई थी. पर पॉलिटिकल राइट्स उनको मिले नहीं थे, ना राइट टू वोट, ना मिनिस्ट्री या पॉलिटिकल ऑफिस. लेटर ऑन इसके लिए उन्होंने प्रोटेस्ट किया. रॉबेस्पियर ने इन सबको क्या कर दिया था, वुमेन्स क्लब वगैरह को बंद करवा दिया था, इलीगल मान लिया था. और उसके बाद फाइनली स्टिल वुमेन प्रोटेस्टेड एंड दे गॉट द राइट आफ्टर 200, यू कैन से अलोंग टाइम 1946 में. अदर वुमेन अराउंड द वर्ल्ड saw the French women as their inspiration, and everywhere women got the right to vote slowly and gradually at different times. And then we studied about one of the revolutionary women who wrote the Declaration of Rights and Women and Citizens, and protested during the Jacobean government and was executed. And so these were the changes that came in the life of women before and after the revolution. Now in our next class, we will end the chapter. We are left with just two or three topics regarding slavery, one of the very important topic of this chapter, and then we will study about the revolution and the everyday life, and we will conclude the chapter by Napoleon and the what was the legacy of the French Revolution. So that is it for today. I suppose everything is clear. If you have any problems, feel free to ask, and so we'll meet in the next class. Bye everyone.